Josh Jenkins, pick six.
That's WWL key. The receiver can't be feeling good, you said there.
Nah, you don't feel good when that happens, man. Pick six the other way, you can't do anything about it.
Brady ain't feeling
Woo,
good.
Give me that.
You're watching this morning on ESPN News. He had two picks, two 40-year-old quarterbacks going at it for the first time in league history. The top two passing leaders, Brady threw two picks. Speaking of week two, Carolina and the Bucs. How about this one? Got to get used to saying this. New Orleans at Las Vegas next Monday night. On ESPN, much more talk about Brady, what went right, what went wrong, coming up in just a bit.
New Orleans and Vegas, that's going to be a lot of gambling.
No doubt about it. Riverboat, or you want to go on the strip? Whatever you want.
A lot of good food.
Minutes away, just a minute away from talking Brady, Cam, Breeze, Trubisky, everybody. Trubisky in Chicago, making people smile. Cubs fans were smiling, Jay, in Chicago as well. Alec Mills, one of the most unexpected no-hitters in recent Major League Baseball history. Kid was making his 15th start in the latter innings. The Brewers didn't even come close to getting a hit in a 12-0 win.
Will only be the Cubs' luck that this will happen on the opening weekend for NFL football.
Right. This is one of the great moments. Their 16th no-hitter, a legacy franchise. And we barely mentioned it. And we're barely mentioning this, but much like the Cubs no-hitter deserves a ton of attention, the Nuggets from 19 down to force a Game 7 with their win over the Clippers. Remember, the Nuggets were down 3-1 to the Jazz and rallied to win. Now they're down 3-1 to the Clippers. They've tied it at 3. Game 7, Jay, Tuesday night, 9 Eastern on ESPN. No games today. The Eastern Conference Finals between the Heat and Celtics will also start tomorrow. SportsCenter is brought to you by Indeed. If the next step for your business is finding a high-impact hire, try Indeed. Their flexible payment options mean better bang for your buck with no long-term contracts. Indeed will even give you a $75 credit for your first sponsored job post at Indeed.com/high impact. Terms and conditions apply.
It's going to be the first time two 40-year-olds have ever started a football game. How cool is it?
I'm sure I speak for both of us. I think we both pinch ourselves.
And we'll get our first look at Tom Brady. Quarterback sneaks, spikes that ball, Tom Brady.
Walks into the end zone, touchdown.
Brady takes a gun snap.
It's picked up.
It will be a pick six.
Take a 24-7 lead.
Touchdown, O.J. Howard.
It's a nice way to rebound.
Has a man open, 46 yards. Reaches across, touchdown, Emmanuel Sanders.
Tampa Bay falling behind by two touchdowns.
If you're a Tampa Bay Buccaneers fan, you are pulling your hair out.
It's time for Straight Talk Wireless brought to you by, it's time for Straight Talk brought to you by Straight Talk Wireless. Let's get straight to the Shell Pennzoil Performance Line where we're going to talk all things quarterbacks. Brady, Breeze, Trubisky, Darnold, Cam, with our Mike Tannenbaum, ESPN NFL front office insider, and he joins us this morning. Just from your front office view, what did you see from Tom Brady versus Drew Brees that caught your eye the most?
There were some things that was like the old Tom Brady, great anticipation, great placement early on, especially I thought he looked comfortable. But on the two interceptions, there were two mistakes. One was a physical one, the pick six to Janoris Jenkins. He just underthrew the out route. He was late getting the ball out. And then on the interception to Mike Evans, if I was a Buccaneer fan, I'm actually encouraged by it. They saw things differently. Evans broke the route off. It looked like he thought it was zone coverage. Brady thought he was going to take it more vertical. Those things will be cleaned up. We got to remember, this is the first inning for Tampa Bay. They had never been on the field before in a competitive situation. So some good, some bad. But my glass is half full because it's Tom Brady, and that burning desire to win was pretty evident. So I wasn't really surprised, just given the disparity between him and Bruce Arians compared to Drew Brees and Sean Payton, which is a well-oiled machine.
That is correct, Mr. T. So when you talk about well-oiled machine, Captain Comeback, as I would call him, Mitch Trubisky, three touchdowns in the fourth quarter, hit Anthony Miller on a big one late in the game to go ahead. What did you see from him, your guy?
Yeah, Key, I'll tell you what. First of all, I was disappointed that DeAndre Swift didn't hold on to that touchdown so we could be talking about Matt Stafford today. But let's give Mitch Trubisky all the credit in the world. To score three touchdowns in the fourth quarter on the road against a division opponent, that's how quarterbacks should be measured. And I think you nailed it. That 27-yard touchdown to Anthony Miller was a pro throw and something we haven't seen consistently from Trubisky. It was outside the numbers. It was down the field. And the accuracy was placement. If he can do that, that will start to expand opposing defenses, and that'll give him a chance. So if I'm a Bear fan today, I finally saw something to hang my hat on, which is a fourth quarter comeback, good throws, good accuracy from the pocket.
You know, Mike, I hate to put you in this situation, but you're on my show, so therefore I'm going to put you in it. Adam Gase, how long do we wait for the hook to be pulled?
Yeah, Key, I'll tell you what, I was really surprised yesterday. I thought they were going to play better. It was a disappointing effort. It's still year two. I probably err on the side of patience. I know Adam. I went to the playoffs with Adam in Miami. He's a good coach. He's done good things. It hasn't been good enough thus far. They looked poor yesterday. I mean, going into the game yesterday, you would say Jacksonville was the worst team on paper. I thought the Jets looked as bad as any team so far in terms of in week one's performance. But if we're going to be patient, if we want to say that, hey, Sam Darnold didn't have a full year after what happened last year with Mono and everything else, then we should give it a little bit more time here. But Sam Darnold should, and that offense should play better ASAP.
Okay.
Mike, what are your thoughts on the Washington football team?
Yeah, I'll tell you what, Jay. Well, I wasn't really shocked because football is a game of matchups. And when you have five first-round picks in that front, they're going to be hard for anybody to stop. And Philadelphia was missing three starters on the offensive line. I'm not making any excuses. But what I loved Dwayne Haskins' intangibles. I love what he was doing on the sidelines. They were down 17 points, and they could have tucked their tail in and said, hey, this is game one with Coach Rivera. They had all the excuses there, but they didn't. They came back, and they competed, and they won. And they're going to be a hard out because when you can rush the passer and you can get the ball down the field, which Dwayne Haskins can do and score points, Washington's going to be a tough out, and they're going to be an intriguing team to watch. And I'll just tell you, and Key, you know this, when you're facing a team, like who do you double team? Chase Young, Sweat, Kerrigan? They're going to cause a lot of problems for a lot of teams.
I'm with you, Mike. I love seeing Dwayne Haskins also talk to the defensive unit on the sideline, getting them pumped up. I also wanted to ask you, as it relates to leadership, Cam Newton in this Patriots offense, how lethal is it?
The edge of the cliff. I was watching the games last night. One thing I was really surprised by.
Disney.
It's early, maybe too early. Terry Bradshaw.
Never too early.
Chris Collinsworth. Troy Aikman. Mm-hmm. All the guys that either were on the call or talking about the game with the Bucs and the Saints. All of them said, and maybe this is just the society we live in now as sports fans, where like snap judgments come on everything all the time, where each one of them, independent of each other on different networks, said, for those of you that are worried about the Tampa Bay Bucs, hang on, slow down.
That's right.
Nothing to worry about.
Yeah, there's nothing to worry about.
Let's get your thoughts on Tom Brady after Tom tells us what he needs to improve on moving forward.
Well, I think certainly poor execution, and, you know, that's what it comes down to. It's a game of execution, and obviously they, you know, made more plays than we did, and I made some just bad, terrible turnovers, and it's hard to win turning the ball over like that. So that's I obviously got to do a lot better job.
Including two picks that had a pick six involved from Janoris Jenkins. So you guys are kind of in lockstep. I know everybody's sort of, you know, going crazy over Brady and the way that they looked, but those guys that you heard last night talking about the game, you totally agree with them. It's just far too early to do anything, but just be patient.
Well, to be honest with you, I didn't hear anybody. Okay. My observation is from my own eyes telling me, because I was in a place where there was no sound. But you could look at it and you could tell that this is from a lack of not necessarily preparation, but practice, being on the same page, new environment, new situation. You could totally tell. I mean, that's miscommunication, Mike Evans throw. Tom Brady's expecting one thing. Mike Evans is seeing another thing in the secondary. As you look and you see, these sort of things will get better. You running a certain route in the middle of the field, Brady's looking for you to go to the second window, and then all of a sudden you pull up, you think it's zone, he's ready to throw, and as he gets ready to release the ball, he now says, uh-oh, but he says something different, and he lets it go. On the outbreaking route, the Jenkins interception, he was late throwing it, okay? And that'll change. He didn't see Jenkins originally, and once he pulled the ball, the trigger, he was like, uh-oh, it was too late to pull it back. Jenkins kind of fooled him by playing heavy inside, so he kind of stacked a little bit behind the linebacker dropping, and it was a pick six going the other way. All of those things today will be corrected on film. Tomorrow will be corrected on film. The next day corrected on film. And you'll see a much sharper Tom Brady the next go around. You just will. And they'll be – Tampa Bay will be right there in the end.
Look, Brady's betting on the Bucs ceiling, right, with their young talent. When you think about Mike Evans, Chris Godwin, O.J. Howard, these guys, and their penalties totaled an excess of 100-plus yards. That's a classic sign of a team that is just – out of sync. This is going to be a
what
for this team. I don't think they have any problems at all. I think actually the chances of seeing these two teams in the NFC Championship game are pretty high.
That's exactly what Aikman said on the call yesterday. He essentially said, if we're back here calling this NFC Championship
you're not gonna
game
be shocked
with
by
Joe
that.
Buck, he wouldn't be surprised
no,
by
not at all.
At all. Carolina's got Tampa Bay next, and if you're wondering, the team that knocked him off yesterday in the battle of the first 40-year-old quarterbacks to meet, New Orleans will play Las Vegas on ESPN's Monday Night Football. Tonight we got the Steelers and the Giants on Monday Night Football, followed by Tennessee and Denver. Latter game will be called by Lou Riddick. He'll join us at 9 Eastern. We're presented by Progressive Insurance. Drivers